Friends, if you don't mind to get a bit closer. Some of you.
I'm not afraid.
I know you did your COVID test, but. Some of the archaeologists, when they come over here, they don't care about Herod's the Great Palace. They don't care about the story of the revels. What they're here to see is the Roman army machine in action. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that's the best place in the world to see the Roman siege system. The best place in the world, because it's untouched and you can see the whole thing. So many come just for that. And why is that? We are talking about the Jewish story, but I want to remind you, Augustus, okay, something we didn't mention. Augustus was the great Caesar of Rome ever. He ruled Rome for 57 years. And he established what's known as the Pax Romana, the Roman peace. He established the borders of the Roman Empire for the next 400 years. But this peace was achieved by the blood of all the other nations around Rome. So what I'm trying to tell you, that the Jewish story over here is not unique just for the Jews. It's a universal story. And the same thing the Romans did to the Jews over here, they did to other nations all around the world. But here we have a rare case that we have the loser side of the story because of the testimony of Josephus. Yes, we're going to talk about Josephus. He was not here, but he personally interviewed all the commanders that were fighting here. And he knew the rebels. He knew the way of the way they think. And he published his book only a few years after the events. So he could not lie about it. Everybody was still alive. So after saying all that, we want to show you the Roman army siege system. If you wish to step forward and look down. That brought them supply from Engedi. I'm not sure if you can see it, but there is a green patch over there. That's where the slaves brought them the water and food supply. Now, what they did, they built a wall and a city around the city that was 2.5 miles long. And they built it so thoroughly, it's still standing until today. All the soldiers, all together, 2 weeks' time, siege wall 2.5 miles.
Nobody will come out.
You want them to feel they have no hope. You want them to surrender. You want to finish the job as